If you want to track how efficiently you close deals or move information throughout your process, look no further than this video. I'm going to be going into detail about some really cool hacks that you can use inside of your Airtable database to unlock a whole other layer that allows you to really figure out how efficiently you're doing your job. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth Pronovost, and over here at Gap Consulting, we help you to organize and automate your business. So if that's of interest, do check out the links below if you haven't already, and don't miss our upcoming live webinar. We do a weekly live training so that you can learn the exact steps that I use to implement automation. Saves me personally over 20 hours per week. So if you want to reclaim a lot of your time using automation and organizing and automating, you don't want to miss that training. Check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. You can sign up, you'll get all the information. And even if you can't attend live, I'll send you a replay of the training. So check it out below. But without further ado, let's get into the heart of this. We are talking about checking out dates and how we can map the efficiency or the process that we undergo as an organization. So let's start just by jumping into my screen, and you'll see that I have a really simple setup here. I've got some named deals, deal 1, 2, and 3, and then I've got a couple status built. We're gonna say, hey, we made first contact on a particular day, and we have a proposal sent on a day, and this is kind of the process that we track a deal through. The agreement's gonna get signed, we're gonna receive payment. You know, I just made some stuff up. Whatever you wanna put in for your process, of course, is gonna be unique to you. But what we want to track is how long do these projects live at each various stage? How long is something in first contact before it converts to the next stage where we send that proposal? You know, or maybe we want to track like how many of our deals are getting lost at various stages. Like if it went from agreement signed to deal lost, well, maybe there's something wrong in our agreement process that's causing us to lose clients at that stage. There's a lot of different ways you can slice and look at this, but the big takeaway is we want to know what the date is that each of these different stages was hit. So let's take a look. Now, we could say, hey, first contact here, we'll have a proposal sent here, and we'll have agreement signed here, right? So these are the different stages that these different deals are in. So there's a special field type that Airtable allows us called the last modified time. We can use this and we can look at, let's say, the status field. And we can say, hey, I want to look at the status field and I want you to tell me or update whenever that status field changes, right? Maybe we don't want to even include time, so that's no big deal. And sure enough, it's throwing up the date here. So it's saying, hey, a change was made on 8/1. If I have something here where there is no status here yet, then there's no modified. If I make a change to the status, then it's going to show up here. But this is not the complete solution because this in and of itself isn't telling us when we hit the first contact, or it's not telling us when we hit proposal sent stage, etc. So instead, let's do the following. Let's convert last modified to a today field. And I'm going to write a little formula here, and I'm just going to call on today. It's a little formula that's going to always display the current day. Now, I don't need time here, I just want the date. If you want to include time, you should not use the today formula, instead use the now formula. Now, open and close parentheses will actually show you pretty close to the current moment in time. It's usually a few minutes late. But we can go ahead and exclude time and save this up, and sure enough, we're going to get those particular days. Now, what we want to do is build a new field for date of first contact. And we're gonna make this a date field and just go ahead and install that. And I'll do a proposal sent as well so we can get an idea of that. So this is gonna be date of proposal sent. So these are the first two different status that I have, right? First contact was made and then proposal sent was on this next stage. So these are the two stages and I wanna date stamp them with whenever that status occurred the first time. So we're gonna go ahead and build an automation here. The first one is going to be a custom automation, and I'm going to add date of first contact. And my trigger is going to be a record matching conditions. Now, at a minimum, I need to say, look, it's in this deals table. And the condition is that the status is equal to first contact. So as soon as the status is first contact, that will trigger this automation. But I want to add another condition. I don't want it to re-trigger this automation if first contact has already been the status and we go back. So I'm going to add one more condition here. And the second condition is going to be that the date of first contact is empty. Because what we're going to do is actually fill out the date of first contact on the first contact date. And so if there is already a date filled out there, then of course we don't want this automation to trigger again. I'm going to run a test, and it's going to pull in the sampled data of deal number one, because deal one meets these conditions. The status is first contact and the date of first contact is empty. So yes, my test ran successfully. I can go ahead then and update a record. And of course, this is in my deals table. The record that I want to update is the one that triggered this automation. So I bring in the record ID from that. And then what do I want to update? So I want to update the date of first contact. Well, thankfully, I've already put in a formula for today. So when I look at deal one, I have a formula here in the background that's going to tell me exactly what today is. So I can go ahead and bring that date in. So today is going to get updated. So whenever this runs, depending on the day, it will be copied and pasted right into that date field. Let's go ahead and run a test, and we're going to see that, sure enough, it's going to get stamped with the same date that is currently in this field right here. So you can understand then that tomorrow this date field is going to update to 8.2, and if these conditions were met, then it would stamp right here. All right, so that's our first one. We can go ahead and turn this automation on, and then we can copy the automation or duplicate it. And the slight change I'm gonna make here, this time it's going to be done for the date of proposal sent. So I bring that in and I change the status to proposal sent, run a test here, and I'm going to find deal two because deal two matches these conditions. And I'll pop down into my update record, and I don't want to update the date of first contact because that's a timestamp for this status. I want to update the date of proposal sent. So I'll ditch this field and I will add date of proposal sent, and I will make sure to go ahead and update it with today's date. I'll run a test here and we'll see that get updated in our second record. So this is a great way for you to be able to track when certain things occur inside of your database, right? If I turn this automation on and I pop out, I can close my automations. Anytime I make a change to the status, let's look at changing the status for deal three. I make a change to first contact, and within a moment, we're going to update the date that first contact was made, right? And similarly, if I make a change to proposal sent, it's going to update with the day that the proposal was sent. Now, I noticed that mine didn't, so I better pop into my automations and figure out what I goofed on. And sure enough, I changed the status to be proposal sent, but I need to also change the status to be date of proposal sent is empty, right? Because I need to make both of these things match. So proposal sent is the status and the date for sending the proposal has not been filled out yet. Be sure to update your automation. And then we can try this out again, moving it to proposal sent. Cross your fingers that there we go. It got updated, so fair enough, it's working appropriately. Now you can do this for every stage in your business, and you can start to track how long things stay in one particular stage or another. So let's say, for example, instead of the date of first contact being 8-1, maybe instead this was like 7-28. Well, you can then compute how many days it sits in that stage. So you can say days in first stage, write a little formula, do a date time difference. We're going to do a subtraction between the date of first contact and the date of proposal sent in days. And this is going to output and show us that it was in that stage for 4 days. Now, in this particular case, by the way, I flipped those around. So if you want it to show as a positive number, you can either add a negative at the beginning of it, or you can alter the order of these two different dates inside of your formula. Now, in either case, it's telling me, hey, look, something was in this stage of the pipeline for 4 days. So if you want to track how long on average something is in a particular stage, let's say this particular deal was in that first stage for 20 days, and this next one was in there for 4, and you want to know the average, now you have the ability to build an app that is going to show you a summary. So let's go ahead and add the summary block here, and I'll pop that in. And I'm going to simply ask it to look at any view. I'm going to summarize my days in first stage, and I simply want to bring out an average. And I'll say average in first stage. And it's showing me NAN, meaning not a number. This is due to the fact that I have NAN or not a number in this particular field. So what I need to do in order to make my formula just a little bit stronger is only output anything from this formula if I have dates in both of the fields. So I can now copy this and I'll write a quick formula here. I'm going to say if both of these dates exist, date of first contact and date of proposal sent, if they both exist in that condition, then I'm going to output the number of days in between them. Otherwise, nothing will happen here. So I can save this formula, and you see now that the NAN is removed from this first place because I don't have two dates filled out. Again, if you want to copy and paste that formula into your own base, by all means, go ahead and pause the video and grab it. And then I have my two dates here. We know that, you know, between these two discrepancies, I have 20 days and 4 days, total of 24, divided by 2 is 12. And so sure enough, my average of 12 is showing up here automatically. And the best part about this is, if I were to close this and move it into proposal sent, then this is going to get updated thanks to our handy automation in just a moment. There it is. Now that means that it was in the first stage for 0 days because it only sat in stage 1 from 8-1 to 8-1. And so then we have a better or an improved average. So this is a great way for you to track the process of your pipeline based on the efficiency of your operations. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. And if I went too fast, feel free to go back and rewatch or pause the video in any of those spots. Leave any questions you have below, and I look forward to connecting with you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.